The first step is to take this wood blank that's a little over 3/4 inches square and turn it into a 3/4 inch doll. This is beech. I moved to the Logan lathe so I can hold the entire length in a larger chuck. And I'll start off with a 3/8 drill bit. And finally, 1/2 inch. After drilling these, I used a slotted dowel with a piece of sandpaper and sanded the bore. Then I dipped these in shellac and let them sit in the can for a few minutes. Wiped them off, used a paper towel to clean out the bore. When that was dry, I used a 1/2 inch reamer by hand just to clean that up on the inside again. Took a piece of scrap purple heart and turned a 1/2 inch dowel that's about 15/1000ths undersize, and that just falls through there. You can shake that back and forth. And the grain on this is cross grain. I'm going to cut this roughly in half and use that for my plunger. The purple heart's a nice hard wood. When you sand that, it polishes up like a piece of metal. This is one of those delightful times when you find out that your camera or memory card have failed you. So we will jump forward on this project. The flanges were turned on the lathe. This one I made out of plywood so I can get a tongue on here. I can put a hole in there and mount the cylinder like this, or I could use this section to glue it into a hole on another piece of wood. Whichever one I use, I can cut the other one off. And I've got a little lip on here, so when it goes into pipe, it's self-centering. The reason I've gone about this in this manner is the organ is operating 5-6 inches of water, and that's not a whole lot of pressure. This is a bypass piston, and I'm hoping that air will come into the cylinder, travel the length of this pipe, and carry the plunger with it. Air needs someplace to go, so this has been drilled here that intersects with this 1/4 inch hole to give that air an escape route as the plunger comes forward. If I put a pipe in here, like I've done with this one, I then have created a double acting cylinder, which I don't really want. I didn't want to go through the trouble of trying to figure out how to put a spring inside here for spring return, which would just make this thing longer. The conductor is mounted on a linear rail, and he moves back and forth very easily. So I need just enough force on this to move the conductor forward. And I wanted to use a hairspring external to this to return the conductor to the rear position. So this has to put out enough force to move the conductor and stretch a hairspring. And then the spring has to be strong enough to push this back. And that's the part that makes this an experiment. I'm going to hook this up to the air supply that I made from the busker, bellows, and reservoir, and we'll see if this works. When the air supply is running, I will push this valve to open air to go down to the cylinder. So it works. The problem is it doesn't put out much force. It sounds like it does. I use the cylinder, if I load that wood doll in there, it comes out of there with quite a bit of force. The air supply from the busker is only putting out about 5 inches of water. It will not lift the weight of this mechanism. With compressed air, this works pretty well. You don't even have to make a solid connection. If you do, there's a lot of force. And vertically, not a problem. If I put this back here and blow into the hose, it will move the conductor. And it will move it back.